Right now at 10, a former lacrosse pediatrician who eventually pleaded guilty to child sexual assault charges will spend years behind bars. His victims say the trauma will last forever. And lacrosse officials close Cameron Park once again for another round of cleaning. Some residents are now questioning whether the no camping ordinance is actually taking effect. Plus, last day on the bench, Judge Todd Bjerke officially retires from La Crosse County Circuit Court after 16 years.
We're watching WKBT La Crosse. This is News 8 Now at 10.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us for News 8 Now at 10. I'm Ken Kozarowski. A Chippewa County judge has ruled on several motions for a hearing of the teen accused of murdering and then raping a 10-year-old girl. Judge Steve Gibbs says images of Lily Peters' body will not be viewed during a hearing next week. Peters went missing in April of last year and was found a day later in the woods near her home. A teenage boy whose name is not being released told police he strangled Peters to death before having sex with her body. He told investigators he later returned to the scene and covered Peters' body with leaves. The teen is currently held at a juvenile detention center in Eau Claire and is charged as an adult with first-degree intentional homicide, first-degree sexual assault, and first-degree sexual assault of a child younger than 13, resulting in great bodily harm. Now, next week's hearing, if successful for the defense, could move the case to juvenile court. Police are investigating a body found on a La Crosse hiking trail over the weekend. According to an official press release, La Crosse police went to Cunningham and Harvey Streets around 9 Sunday morning to meet with a person who had discovered the body. That person was walking their dog when they found a woman dead in the Bud Hendrickson Trail area. An autopsy was scheduled for today. A former Mayo Clinic Health System pediatrician and ICU doctor has been sentenced for sex crimes against children. 41-year-old Joseph Potaruca was sentenced today to 5 years in prison and 14 years of extended supervision for the second-degree sexual assault of a child. He will also spend 6 months in La Crosse County Jail for an additional charge of fourth-degree sexual assault. Before sentencing today, several of Potaruca's victims elected to speak to the court.
Joe won't get better. What he did to us has changed us and will affect us forever. Joe put a life sentence on us and we did nothing wrong. Joe deserves the same life sentence he gave us.
Potaruca had pled guilty to 2 counts of sexual assault back in May of this year. A former Toma teacher has been convicted for sex crimes against a student. 74-year-old Ann Nelson Cook was convicted on 25 counts of repeated sexual assaults of a 14-year-old male student during the 2016-17 school year. Her sentencing is scheduled for October 27th. Now, Nelson Cook was released into the community with GPS monitoring. According to the Monroe County DA, Nelson Cook potentially faces over 600 years of prison time. A La Crosse man accused of a 2021 drive-by shooting will spend 4 years in a state prison. 22-year-old Julius Lloyd pled no contest to felony first-degree recklessly endangering safety, possession of cocaine with intent to deliver, and discharging a firearm from a vehicle. Lloyd was accused of firing a bullet that hit a man in the hip. That gunshot was nearly fatal. He also fired other rounds that struck 3 houses on the 1700 block of Prospect Street. The 4-year sentence includes an additional 5 years of extended supervision after his release. A former Vernon County administrative assistant is accused of embezzling county funds. According to the Vernon County Sheriff, officers have arrested 30-year-old Kayla Fortney last week after a 6-week investigation. That investigation led them to believe Fortney had embezzled county funds, and she was booked for theft of more than $10,000. She was in court Friday and released on a $5,000 signature bond. She's expected back in court September 6th. A pleasant start temperature-wise to the work week and perhaps a windows open night in these late few hours. Let's bring in Bill Grawl for the latest. Bill?
Hi, Ken. I sure think so. Whenever we've got comfortable temperatures and fairly low humidity for the middle part of the summer, yeah, I'd say open up those windows for sure, but I guess to each his or her own. All right, let's check those highs today. Again, another comfortable day, comfortable weekend after our stormy Friday night with the strong to severe storms. 84 was the high on Saturday, 82 yesterday, 83 today, 82 in Eau Claire, 81 in Winona, Black River, River Falls, and Sparta, 80 degrees in Viroqua. All is quiet tonight. We've got mainly clear sky and just some high clouds off to the north and west, which continue to fade as they move in our direction. Most spots in the mid to upper 60s, even some 50s, 58 at Volk Field, and also 58 in Sparta, and 59 in Black River Falls. So a lot of bright moonlight tonight. It'll be full tomorrow night, mostly clear, maybe some patchy valley fog late tonight, early tomorrow, thanks to the light winds. And again, there's that windows open night, lows in most spots in the 50s, including 59 in La Crosse. I'll have the rest of the work week forecast in just a few minutes.
Sounds good. Thanks, Bill. La Crosse's Cameron Park closed this morning for, quote, cleaning and pressure washing. Now, fences were put up around the park as the cleaning started, and the unsheltered residents who live there were moved. The city has done cleanings at Cameron and Burns Parks roughly once a month for the last couple of months. A city official has told us these efforts are for public safety and because the parks are not built to handle so many people around the clock. And this decision comes weeks after the La Crosse Common Council passed an ordinance that effectively bans overnight camping in city parks. But since the mayor signed the ordinance earlier this month, the number of tents at Cameron have stayed the same. Now, the city assures News 8 Now that the ordinance has taken effect. And instead of ordering citations to members of the unsheltered population, police are taking an educational approach, trying to help those residents locate services that can help them get back on their feet. But for some, the decision to routinely close the parks does not sit well.
Instead of taking care of the problem and solving it, they're just masking it and forcing people out, which is making people start thinking that it's a conservation thing, forcing people to go in one area. You know, not all these people out here are bad people.
Now, La Crosse police say citations may come soon for those violators who willfully refuse to relocate when told to do so. Derek Van Orden has canceled a meeting today with the town of Campbell that would have discussed federal funding for battling PFAS contamination. Now, a spokeswoman for Van Orden's office says the cancellation is not connected to the backlash the congressman has received for his treatment of U.S. Senate pages late last week. Last Thursday, he reportedly shouted expletives at the pages, who are teenagers who work as senator assistants, when he saw them lying on the floor, resting or taking pictures of the Capitol Rotunda's ceiling while the Senate was in a late session. There's no word yet on when the meeting with the town will be rescheduled. Governor Evers and the Wisconsin DNR have announced new funding for communities to help address PFAS contamination in wastewater. Now, the new funding will be included as part of the Clean Water Fund program. That program gives financial aid to municipalities for infrastructure projects by providing reduced interest rate loans. At least $2.5 million is available for municipalities to complete projects that reduce or eliminate PFAS contamination. The funds have been made available through the bipartisan infrastructure law. No parking signs have been temporarily posted on some La Crosse streets. The signs were posted earlier today. A contractor is set to begin chip sealing the streets tomorrow, and that's scheduled to last until August 4th. The project could be postponed today depending on weather conditions. Some of the streets impacted are Avon, St. Andrew, and Winnesheek streets. A full list of those affected is on news8000.com. After 16 years on the La Crosse Circuit Court bench, Judge Todd Bjerke has retired. The 65-year-old served in the Marines before beginning a legal career spanning three decades. He was first elected to Circuit Court in 2007 and re-elected twice. He was also instrumental in the creation of the Veterans Court in La Crosse. Now, we spoke to Bjerke earlier this summer, and he had a message for his successor.
I hope that they are as open as I am to listening to the litigants, applying what they know from the facts to the law to come up with a good, equitable decision in all cases. Treat everybody, hopefully, with respect.
Since that conversation, Governor Evers has appointed Bjerke's court commissioner, Mark Huseman, to serve on the bench for the next year. Bjerke, meanwhile, plans to remain part of several organizations that are dedicated to mental health awareness. Coming up, service with a smile. A La Crosse MTU driver is our latest hometown hero, and later, a bittersweet sign-off. A Winona State administrator takes to the airwaves on his last day on the job.
This week's Hy-Vee hot deals are a value pack of Hy-Vee chicken breast, $1.99 a pound. Stamilt red cherries, $1.66 a pound when you buy a 3-pound pack. And lots of matzo pizza, only $5.97 all week long at Hy-Vee.
Get 11% off everything at Menards. The Suncast 7x7 Defender Storage Shed is built with reinforced walls, floor, and roof to withstand heavy loads, whether big or small. Now you can store it all with a 7x7 Defender Storage Shed. Just $849.99 after rebate. Check out Menards' huge selection of concrete landscape blocks. We have the perfect block for your next project. These 16x16 patio blocks are only $2.99 each after 11% off at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Two for $7 every day. Classic beef and cheddar hot. Two of those things for just $7. Arby's, we have the meat.
So many hotels.
Trouble booking the family vacay? Come on. Comfort has free hot breakfast for the whole fam.
They have waffles.
And splendid pools. Book direct at choicehotels.com.
This week's Hy-Vee hot deals are Hy-Vee Choice Reserve Bacon Wrapped Sirloins, $2.99. General Mills Family Size Cereal, $2.98. And six pack Pepsi products, only $2.99 each when you buy four. All week long at Hy-Vee.
Hometown Heroes is brought to you by The Board Store Home Improvement.
A smile can make or break a person's day. That's the motto one La Crosse MTU bus driver has lived his career by, a career that spanned over four decades. News 8 Now's Dua Israr introduces us to our July hometown hero.
For much of John Steele's life, he's driven people from point A to point B.
I was so excited. I was making $5 an hour when I got hired then.
The La Crosse MTU bus driver has been welcoming people on his route for nearly 45 years.
Everyone always knows my grandpa because he's the bus driver that always helped everyone.
Steele is semi-retired. It wasn't just the love for his career that brought him back behind the wheel.
Mother-in-law moved in, but I love her to death, but I just needed to get away once in a while.
Steele says one of his biggest accomplishments is winning third place at the MTU Bus Rodeo.
My wife said, they called your name. They called your name. I had a chicken leg in my hand because I was eating chicken. I started walking up the stage. She said, put the chicken down.
His favorite part of the job, though, is the people he gets to meet.
Some I've watched grow up to have kids and their kids have kids. It's just a very interesting job.
Reporting in La Crosse, Dua Israr. News 8 Now.
If you know someone who goes above and beyond in their community, you can nominate a hometown hero. Just go to news8000.com and fill out the form on the website. A Minnesota teenager says a recent act of kindness wasn't intended to go viral, but it sure has now. 13-year-old Jackson Prell was walking through his neighborhood with friends recently who started ding-dong ditching some houses. He says he saw one house with a camera and went up and decided to say something nice.
And you matter, all right? There's always going to be somebody that cares about you. And you're a good person. No matter what people say, you matter.
I saw some kids at the doorbell and I watched it and I was like, wow, that was really powerful.
Ashley, the homeowner, got that notification while on vacation. She works in mental health and decided to put it on TikTok. It's already reached millions of screens within a week. Still ahead, not your average landscaper. A rural Minnesota family is rethinking lawn care service with some furry employees.
And I'm meteorologist Bill Graw, looking dry tonight and tomorrow. Slight chance we could see some rain on Wednesday. I'll have the details of my 8-day forecast after the break.
Founded on hard work, dedication, respect, and integrity, we at Maxwell White understand the importance of home comfort. Maxwell White strives to provide our customers with a positive experience every time. Maxwell White, plumbing done right.
Hello.
Yes, this is Nicolay Law.
Well, no, I'm not actually, but I'm familiar with this work.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. If they want the real Nicolay, they should get the real Nicolay. Thank you. Russell Nicolay here. Yeah, we can help you.
In a world full of choices, make sure you get the real Nicolay.
You have a trash can here?
That's all right, maybe we'll get you one. Let's get you a trash.
Are you ready to start a meaningful career in healthcare? Are you looking for a job that fits your work-life balance? Become a certified direct care professional today. and help those who need you most in your community. WISC Caregiver Careers makes it easy with free online training and a $500 bonus. See your name on Wisconsin's CDCP registry. Start your career today at WISCCaregiverCDCP.com.
Jolivet Family Farms. There's no substitute for homegrown freshness. Jolivet's homegrown triple sweet corn is picked fresh daily. Join us Sundays 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. for our roasted sweet corn and charcoal brats. Jolivet's also features homegrown carrots, sweet onions, peppers, beets, cabbage, dill, tomatoes, cucumbers, blueberries, and so much more. Find distinctive crafts and decor. Take home some cookies, breads, bars, or pies from our homemade bakery. Buy fresh, buy local. Open daily year-round. Jolivet Family Farms, West Salem.
Now is the time to seize the day.
Now is the time to seize the day.
Answer the call and don't delay.
Answer the call and don't delay. Wrongs will be righted if we're united.
They started out delivering the papers and ended up making the headlines. Toma Area Community Theater presents Disney's Newsies.
Like it or not, we're drawing near.
August 4th at 7 p.m. and August 6th at 1 p.m. Order your tickets online today at tomaact.com.
Sick of running out of hot water? The professionals at Maxwell White are here to handle all of your water heater needs. Our licensed technicians can install, repair, or replace any type of water heater with same day or next day service. Call Maxwell White. Plumbing done right.
Join La Crosse's number one remodeler. Good pay and benefits. No weekends. $2,000 sign-on bonus. Work with the best. The Ford Store Home Improvements. Apply online or in person.
You expect more. So thank you for watching News 8 Now.
Eliminating weeds without the use of chemicals or manpower. Sounds too good to be true. But in rural Minnesota, a farm animal is making it possible, as John Lauritsen explains.
Come on, girls, come on.
On a farm near the town of Renville.
If there's stuff to eat on the inside, they're happy.
Garrett Hovland doesn't need a chainsaw or a tractor. He's clearing out this grove with goats.
So we got a couple of goats and started with that. And as you can hear in the background, we got a few more now.
Garrett is part of Goats on the Go. It's possible you've seen these animals eating buckthorn and weeds around solar panels in the Twin Cities. It's a concept Garrett was pretty sure would work in other parts of the state as well. The goats work fast. 40 of them can clear out an acre in 4 to 5 days. That's because they're more like browsers than grazers.
So they'd rather eat up into the trees. They're more like a deer.
If someone asks for their services, Garrett and his family round up the herd in a trailer and bring them to the site. They put up an electric fence to keep the goats in and predators out. It's like a traveling band with a big appetite.
Is there anything they won't eat? Like burning weed sometimes, they don't eat as much, but then sometimes they do.
I was thinking another thing, but...
Garrett's wife, Holly, wasn't so sure about the idea at first, but now spends most of her summer days chasing 4 kids and 75 goats. The entire family gets in on the act.
Go find your buddies.
It was just a neat way to get to use what we have for another purpose of what they were created for. So I just thought, yeah, let's give it a try.
It's safe to say that goats in a grove are just as happy as pigs in mud.
We didn't know what to expect as we just started this summer, but it's been going really well, and we've enjoyed doing it as a family.
Well, I think I'm sold. I would love to see that done in person. And Bill, it would have been a great day here in the Cooley region for someone to bring in a herd of goats to maybe do some landscaping outside.
Yeah, who wants to mow, right? Just bring in a herd of goats.
That's
that
right.
Sounds good to me. And hey, they're kind of cute, fun to watch too,
yes.
Right? All right, let's check that allergy report. And we are looking at medium symptoms tomorrow and Wednesday for weeds. Low for ragweed, but that's about to change as we head into the month of August, which is crazy to say. It starts tomorrow, and then high symptoms both days for mold spores. Check out this time lapse from earlier this evening. Skies were clear. Look at that afterglow. You can see the rays of the sun even when it's behind the southeastern Minnesota bluffs there. Just some beautiful images and colors in that western sky earlier this evening. Skies are clear now. 83 was the high, 55 the low, so a little short of that average high of 85, but very close to average, 103 and 47 the records. No rainfall today, 4.44 inches for the month. That is about 0.2 above average, but we're still over 2 inches below average for the year. 68 degrees right now out at the airport, 69 out here at the station, I should say. Winds are calm and the Mississippi dropping 5.09 feet. 67 for you folks in Eau Claire, and your wind is calm as well. The Chippewa River slowly dropping as well. Temperatures are warmest off to our west here, still in the 70s to around 80 degrees locally. Most spots are in the mid to upper 60s, although our traditional colder spots have already slipped into the 50s, 59 in Black River Falls, Sparta, and over towards Volk Field. Dew points are pretty comfortable for late July, mid 50s to around 60 degrees, so that's in that comfortable range, and they should stay in the upper 50s to near 60 overnight. So that's what I'm talking about in terms of a windows open night with comfortable humidity levels. Winds are calm, and that's why I do have a slight chance for some patchy valley fog once again overnight early tomorrow morning. Otherwise, skies are clear, high pressure in control. Boy, a lot of monsoonal moisture flowing up from the south and west may interact with this disturbance moving across southern Canada to bring a slight chance of storms around here on Wednesday. Not tonight or tomorrow, clear to partly cloudy through that stretch. And then as we head into Wednesday and that disturbance and frontal boundary gets closer, could see some showers and thunderstorms try to develop to our north. And then you can see them in the afternoon and try to dipping to the south and east into Wednesday evening. Even an outside chance for a strong to isolated severe storm during the afternoon and evening. Just a level one risk for our northern counties for some wind and hail. I'll keep an eye on that for you for Wednesday afternoon and evening. Highs tomorrow, a little bit warmer, right around 86 or 87 degrees in the La Crosse area. Most spots will see highs between about 82 and 86 degrees, which is pretty typical for the first day of August. So for tonight, 59, mostly clear. Again, some patchy valley fog possible late tonight, early tomorrow morning. Tomorrow, 87, a sunny to partly cloudy sky. That slight chance of storms on Wednesday, primarily in the afternoon and evening. Pretty warm though, 89 and 91 on Thursday, back in the mid 80s on Friday. Slight chance of storms on Saturday, small chance on Sunday as well, with highs in the low to mid 80s. And then next Monday and Tuesday, looking dry. I don't know about you, Ken, but my goodness, August 1st already tomorrow. What do you think?
Flying by. This year has been absolutely crazy. Bill, thank you so much. Coming up next in sports, the PDC Legion baseball team still alive at the state tournament, and the Brewers hoping to put their weekend series against Atlanta in the rearview mirror. They've got the lowly Nationals tonight. Rob's got the highlights next.
Right now at Home World Rugs, get something for nothing. Pay nothing for sales tax and pay nothing down with interest-free financing on the area's best in-stock selection of rugs. The something for nothing sale right now at Home World Rugs.
Air conditioning stopped working? Tired of finding ways to stay cool? Don't sweat it. Give G&T Heating and Air Conditioning a call. They'll have you feeling cool as a cucumber without having to resort to, well, alternative methods.
Call G&T.
For the best heating and air conditioning guaranteed.
With most value menus, more cheese means spending more cheddar. But Taco John's Valuest menu isn't most value menus. Now get our Nacho Crunch Burrito with chicken for just $3. Or get it with beef for just $2. Only on the Valuest menu at Taco John's.
At Batteries Plus, we bring power to your life. Extreme heat is tough on your car battery. If you're not sure how much life is left in your car or truck battery, visit us for a free battery test today.
So that no matter what mess you brought into this church today, no matter what addiction and what struggle, no matter how many times you've doubted God or questioned God, that because of Jesus Christ, God's not holding it over your head. Instead, there is this amazing grace, there is this unconditional love that you and I can say, God doesn't just put up with us. God loves us.
Join Pastor Mike Novotny each Sunday. Watch Time of Grace on Channel 8, WKBT.
It's patio closeout time at Home Seasonal Concepts. Get an extra 10% off sale prices on patio sets, wicker, fire tables, and more. Like this Orleans dining set for just $19.79. Patio closeouts, now at Home Seasonal Concepts.
Covering all of the exciting action from your community, here's News 8 Now Sports.
As we close out July, high school football teams throughout the Coulee region are gearing up to kick off camp tomorrow. As we turn the calendar to August, but the Legion baseball season not over yet. PDC still hoping to bring home a state title. Prairie du Chien hosting the Class A tournament. They were taking on Jackson this afternoon. First inning, PDC going right to work. Thomas Maher goes back up the box. Colton Thompson scores on the RBI single, makes it 1-0. Later in the inning, Bryce Lenzendorf chops one over to short. Jackson gets the out at third, but another run comes in for PDC. It's 4-0 after one. Let's go to the third now. Two on for Noah Pedretti. He's going to bloop one in a center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Two more runs are going to come in a score. Dawson Eastman is going to come home, slide in safe. Two-run single makes it 6-0 Prairie, and the boys in green kept pouring it on. Again, it's Lenzendorf, this time going the other way for a base hit. Pedretti comes racing in from second. All PDC in this one. They get the shutout win. 14-0 the final over Jackson. They'll play Denmark tomorrow at 1. PDC needs to win that game to force a winner-take-all championship game against Denmark at 4 p.m. Find me a team hotter than the Loggers. Lacrosse storming into the All-Star break on a 5-game winning streak. They made it look easy over the weekend against Mankato. Loggers have won 5 straight. Check out these numbers for the month of July. Loggers going 22-5 this month. Lacrosse is 33-25 overall. That's good enough for first place in the Great Plains East Division, 1 game up on Duluth. Loggers get a much-deserved break for the next few days, but Lacrosse is back home at the Lumberyard Thursday night to open up a 2-game set against St. Cloud. Good news for the Brewers, they don't have to play the Braves again, at least until the postseason, if that's the matchup we get. Milwaukee struggling big time against the best team in baseball for the second straight weekend. Brewers losing 3 straight, now they trail the Reds by a half game in the NL Central. But the Crew back at it tonight in the nation's capital, taking on the Nats. Milwaukee down a run in the 6th, but Andrew Monasterio comes up clutch. He delivers a base hit into right field. Sal Frelick scores. RBI single ties the game at 2. Next inning, Joey Weimer at the dish. He's going to crank this one to dead center. Way back, and that ball is way out of here. Solo shot for Weimer. Puts Milwaukee on top 3-2. Bottom 7 now. Nats answer back. Runners on the corners for Lane Thomas. He smacks a base hit in a left. It's going to tie the game at 3. Then later in the 7th, 2 runners on for Joey Meneses. He shatters his bat, but that's going to drop in for a base hit. 2 runners are going to come in to score. Broken bat, 2-run single for Meneses puts the Nationals on top by 2, and that proves to be the difference in this one. Milwaukee goes down in order in the 9th. Christian Yelich goes down swinging to end it. Brewers drop their 4th straight game, 5-3 the final tonight in D.C. As for the trade deadline, we're getting closer and closer. Teams have until tomorrow to make some last-minute deals, and Milwaukee making a move before tonight's game. The Brewers acquiring veteran utility man Mark Canha from the Mets. The 34-year-old is batting .245 this year. 6 homers, 29 runs batted in, but he can play multiple positions. First base, outfield, can also DH for the Brew Crew. Milwaukee sends right-hander Justin Jarvis to the Mets. He's currently at AAA. And finally, tomorrow is what we've all been waiting for. Football fields all throughout the Cooley region will look just like this one on Tuesday as the high school football season officially gets underway. Teams are allowed to open up training camp on August 1st. This was the scene at Central High just a couple weeks back. The Riverhawks were using one of their 5 allotted off-season practices to get some work in. But on Tuesday, the real journey begins. We're just a little over 2 weeks from the first regular season game of the year. Riverhawks get a Thursday night game on August 17th.
Yep. That first week's always a little interesting. You get a little taste on Thursday night. We got a couple local games. Sure. And then Friday, everything hits the ground running.
How do you feel? I know it's not Ohtani.
Mark Canha.
Serviceable player.
Serviceable. I mean, I wanted Ohtani. I wanted a big splash, but we got to take what we can get.
Yeah, maybe tomorrow we'll see something happen.
Yeah, fingers crossed.
Yeah, we'll see.
Rob, thanks very much. We got more news right after this.
We know taking your child to the dentist can feel like pulling teeth, but at Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, your child arrives with a smile and leaves with specialized oral care tailored to them. Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, where we have big fun taking care of little teeth.
I'm going to say something I want you to think about. Wealthy people ask, how much? People who struggle with their money ask, how much a month? If you're borrowing for everything you purchase, you're buying everything on time, this can lead to a life of financial mediocrity. I think you deserve much better than that. If you'd like to learn more, give me a call at Firefighters Credit Union.
'Cause everybody's welcome. Firefighters Credit Union. Sagging, bouncing, or uneven floors? Call American Waterworks. Standing water or high humidity? Call American Waterworks. Nasty odors or dangerous mold? Call American Waterworks. Critters, bugs, or other pests? That's right, call American Waterworks. It's a fact. Crawl space problems don't get better with time, but they do get better when you call American Waterworks. Call American Waterworks today.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now get 2.9% financing for 66 months plus $1,500 flex buy cash on Bronco Sport, Escape, and Edge. Only at your local Northland Ford dealers.
For over 40 years, La Crosse Glass and Overhead Door has been the go-to company for anything glass and door. We offer a large stock inventory of CEHI garage doors to help you find the perfect fit. As a locally owned business, we take pride in our work and always get the job done. From commercial glass and glazing to residential glass and CEHI garage doors, we have the experience and expertise to help you. Call or visit our website today.
We know taking your child to the dentist can feel like pulling teeth, but at Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, your child arrives with a smile and leaves with specialized oral care tailored to them. Pediatric Dentistry of Onalaska, where we have big fun taking care of little teeth.
It's a bittersweet day for a Winona State University administrator. Scott Olson has served his final day as Winona State's president, a role he has had for 11 years. His last few hours on the job are not behind a prototypical desk, though. It's behind a mic at KQAL, the independent student-run radio station on campus. He's hosted radio shows throughout his presidency, always dabbling with several musical themes.
You can have a lot of fun in the radio. College radio has the most flexibility, so I've always loved being on a college radio station where you can play what you want, when you want.
Now, starting tomorrow, he will start work as Chancellor of the Minnesota State Colleges and Universities System. Says the move brings him closer to family and it's a big opportunity, but it doesn't make leaving any easier.
I will miss Winona State so much. Winona's been a great community. All of southeastern Minnesota has been a great place to live, and it's hard to leave today.
We wish him luck. We'll be right back.
We're busy. I get it. So Stanton Optical works with your schedule. Buy online, pick up in store same day, and get a free fitting. I mean, look at my to-do list. Skip the wait. Get your kids' glasses made the same day, only at Stanton Optical.
Arby's, 2 for $7 every day. Arby's crispy classic chicken sandwich. Two of those things for just $7. Arby's, we have the meat.
America, it's time to gear up and get out there in a new Ford vehicle. And it all starts at your local Ford dealer during the Discover Summer Sales Event. Choose from a great selection of trucks and SUVs equipped with the tech and comfort you need to discover your best summer ever. With a large inventory in stock, now is the best time to trade in, trade up, and discover summer with Ford. Now get 3.9% financing for 60 months plus $3,500 in total savings on Ford F-150 XLT Super Crew. Only at your local Northland Ford dealers.
So many hotels.
Trouble booking the family vacay? Come on.
Comfort has free hot breakfast for the whole fam.
They have waffles.
And splendid pools.
Cannonball! Book direct at choicehotels.com.
We make musicians' plugs, which basically just act like turning the volume down. So all of the frequencies come through, but just at a lesser volume. We also do make custom stage monitors as well.
Musicians, DJs, that's where a lot of people lose their hearing when the ambient is so loud. So it's nice that you can isolate that. A custom fit, so yeah, it pretty much blocks what you want.
Better Hearing Center, 11th and Main, Onalaska, next to St. Pat's Church.
Jolivet Family Farms. There's no substitute for homegrown freshness. Jolivet's homegrown triple sweet sweet corn is picked fresh daily. Join us Sundays 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. for our roasted sweet corn and charcoal brats. Jolivet's also features homegrown carrots, sweet onions, peppers, beets, cabbage, dill, tomatoes, cucumbers, blueberries, and so much more. Find distinctive crafts and decor. Take home some cookies, breads, bars, or pies from our homemade bakery. Buy fresh, buy local. Open daily year-round. Jolivet Family Farms, West Salem.
At Stanton Optical, you get great value on eye care, including contacts. Right now, get a one-year supply of AccuView Oasis and an eye exam for only $189. Scan now to book your eye exam. Yay, technology!
Most overnight low of about 59 in La Crosse. Tomorrow, 87, either side of 90 on Wednesday and Thursday. Slight chance of storms on Wednesday.
All right, thanks a lot, Bill, and good luck to PDC Legion.
Absolutely. They need two wins tomorrow, though.
All right. Wish them luck for sure, and we will see you tomorrow.